We are really thrilled to have a really great speaker here with us tonight, someone who's been such a supporter of the same-sex marriage initiative, of Dana's work in general, certainly of Fair Michigan. And you've known him in one way or another for many years. Perhaps you were his student at Way State, or perhaps you've heard him on Michigan Public Radio, or perhaps you've read him in any number of publications. He's a political analyst, he's a pundit, he is our keynote speaker tonight, and we are thrilled to welcome Jack Lessenberry.
Thank you very much, Amy, for that kind introduction. Is the microphone working?
Yes.
Good or bad, as your perspective may be. I'm here because Dana Nessel asked me to come. And you don't say no to the next Attorney General of the state of Michigan. Especially when she knows the kind of stuff about me that Dana does. She knows what I did in college. I was at Michigan State University as a student at the same time Loretta Simon was, but we don't want to go into that. I know, by the way, also, that this has to be a completely nonpartisan evening, and so I feel the need to say that whether you're a Republican, or a Democrat, or an Independent, or a communist like myself, as long as you all vote for Dana, it'll be good. This is a woman who has committed the justice, equal justice under law, for everyone. She stood up when it counted for civil and human rights, and at the same time, she hasn't been afraid to put car thieves and pimps and child pornographers in jail. Had she been Attorney General during the last several years, Larry Nassar would have been stopped and Michigan State exposed far earlier than those things actually happened. Even though she paid me to say these things. And now then, allow me to out myself. I am straight. An old, straight, white male of Anglo-Saxon. I am boring and conventional. No diversity awards here. But I am, and I am, seriously, honored beyond words that you would ask me to be with you tonight. You are heroes, many of you. You endure insults and snubs and worse, sometimes daily, simply for having the courage to be who you are as human beings. Thank you for having the courage to demand recognition for your humanity. You know, the fight we're engaged in isn't easy. We live in a country where almost 63 million people voted for Donald Trump. We live in a state that has been brutally gerrymandered to give the religious right permanent political control in our legislature. Supposedly, there's no way they rig it, so there's no way we can ever win. Well, screw that. This is the modern civil rights movement. Last night, I looked up Fair Michigan's mission and vision statements after I spent a few hours playing Candy Crush. And I found them very inspiring. The mission statement says, Fair Michigan seeks to secure equal protection under the law based on gender, gender identity, sex, and sexual orientation. The vision statement says, our vision is to create a Michigan with the presence and contributions of everyone, welcomed and celebrated, regardless of their gender, gender identity, sex, or sexual orientation, where intolerance is challenged and defeated, where justice prevails, and where the civil rights of all people are valued and respected. Well, to me, those words are stirring in the Declaration of Independence. I do have something with those who look like me and are members of the so-called religious right or the alt-right, which is a different religious variant spelling for Nazi. They don't think we should exist. And I wish Fair Michigan didn't exist either, but for different reasons. I want to live in a world where Fair Michigan doesn't exist, because it doesn't need to exist. For all the values in that vision statement. Are so widely accepted that we don't need a therapist any more than we need a special group looking out for the rights of fat, gray-haired, old white men. But we're going to have to fight to get there. We're going to have to fight a whole lot of battles, and we won't win all of them. It isn't 2 steps forward and 1 back. It's 3,000 steps forward, and maybe 2,950 steps back, but we have to keep fighting. We need to let Governor Snyder and the legislature know it is simply unacceptable to appoint a homophobic preacher from Jackson to the Michigan Civil Rights Commission, no matter what color he is. And we need to stop listening to the people who tell us that if we're nice enough to the clowns in the legislature, they may someday include LGBTQ people in the Elliot Larson Civil Rights Bill. At least the ones who dress nicely and don't have any tattoos. Well, as I told Carrie Moss a couple of years ago, and I got her mad, Carrie Moss is a great civil libertarian, but she's gotten it wrong here. Thinking these lawmakers will ever help us is an insult to our own. I know these creatures. I'm not talking about Steve Vita. I know these creatures. They will never do that. And besides, they can't give you folks rights. We all already have those rights. We always have them. We will make them see and accept what we do. Back in the Civil Rights and Vietnam War protest days, before Dana was born, one of my heroes was a folk singer, Phillips. He once did a parody of people like those who would tell the transgender community to be patient. He said, "They'll listen close with open ears and help us out in a couple hundred years. But don't push them whatever you do or you'll get those extremists back in." Well, fuck that. We need to push that. We all know the song, "We Shall Overcome." Well, my favorite two songs from the Civil Rights era are less well-known. One by Melvina Reynolds that went like this. I won't sing, don't worry. "It isn't nice to block the doorway. It isn't nice to go to jail. There are nicer ways to do it, but the nice ways always fail. We've tried negotiations in the token picket line. Mr. Charlie didn't see us, and he might as well be blocked. Now you say that we're not nice, but when we deal with men of ice, we don't mind. It isn't nice, it isn't nice. You told us once, you told us twice, but if that's freedom's price, we don't mind." The other song became the anthem for the best series ever of the Civil Rights Movement. The lines I'm thinking of go like this. "I know the one thing we did right was the day we started the fight, keep your eyes on the prize, hold on. I know the big thing we did wrong was staying in the wilderness too long, keep your eyes on the prize, hold on. That's what we need to do." I have a good friend and former student who's a very talented writer and editor and radio broadcaster in Wyoming. And I told her I wanted to propose they build a statue to Matthew Shepard in the state capitol, Laramie, and name the legislative office building after him. There are, I'm afraid, going to be more Matthew Shepards in this country, but not as many as otherwise if you do what you need to do. And we probably need more stone walls also. And if you do, keep fighting. Sweeping wherever possible, educating, teaching, showing people that we all have a lot in common. Well, maybe we'll be able to look forward to the day when a person who happens to be openly gay or bi or transgender or queer announces that they're going to run for governor or senator or congressman or president of the United States. But that's not the important part. The important part, what's really important, is building a world where, on that day, when they declare their candidacy, the first question any reporter is likely to ask them is, "How are you going to fix the world?" Because the day that finally happens, you and me and we and humanity will finally have won. Thank you very much.